type of the gate is NOT gate. NOT, NOT. Or it can also be called as inverted. NOT gate or inverted. For the NOT gate, there is only one input and one output. This is the symbol of the NOT gate. The symbol of the NOT gate. It has only one input, let it be A, and only one output Y, that is equal to A bar. Bar indicates the complement or inversion. It can also be represented by prime, or can also be represented by prime. This one is called as a prime and this one is called as the bar. That indicates the digital circuits complement operation. The complement means for 0, its complement is equal to 1. For 1, its complement is equal to 0. Or simply in other words, for a NOT gate, if A is the input and Y is the output, if you apply a logic 0 at its input, it produces a one output. If the input is 1, it produces a 0 output. If the input is 0, it produces 1 output. If the input is 1, it produces a 0 output. That is a function of the NOT gate. So this is the truth table of NOT gate, and this is the logic symbol, and this is the output expression. Y equal to A bar or A prime. In digital circuits, bar indicates complement. Indicates a complement. For your reference, once again I have to consider the OR gate. OR gate. For the OR gate, for a two input OR gate, this is the logic symbol. And this is the output expression. And this is the truth table. For a two input gate, there are 4 possible input combinations: 00, 01, 10, and 11. What is the function of an OR gate? It produces high output when any one or all the input or more than one input is high. When any one input or more than one input is high. So in this case, it produces high output, high output, high output. When it produces low output, when all the inputs are low. This is the logic symbol for a two input OR gate. Output expression. Y equal to A plus B, and this is the truth table. For a 3 input OR gate, ABC are the inputs and output expression y is equal to a plus b plus c. And its output expression for a three input gate, there are 8 possible input combinations and it could be of 3, that is equal to 8. So there are 8 possible input combinations. For your convenience, write the input combinations as from one bit, right? It has a 3-bit binary numbers from 000 to 111. So 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. So OR gate produces high output for any one or more than in one inputs are high. So simply in other words, it produces a low output when all the inputs are low. So this is the logic symbol. These two are the logic symbols and these two are truth tables and these two are the output expressions for an 2-input and 3-input OR gates. Next, consider the next type of gate, NOR gate. NOR gate. It's a negation of OR gate. Negation of OR gate, NOR gate. Simply in other words, it is equivalent to OR gate followed by a NOT gate. OR gate followed by a NOT gate, and it is same as with the. So this is the OR gate symbol followed by a NOT gate. So what is the output of this one? A plus B. What is the output of this one? A plus B whole bar. So Y is equal to A plus B whole bar. So that is output expression for NOR gate. What is the output expression for NOR gate? A plus B whole bar. Actually, this is not the logic symbol. So to draw the logic symbol, so simply write a bubble, and a small bubble. Bubble means a small circuit at the output of the logic symbol of OR gate. A simpler word, this one can be replaced with so what is this one? Logic symbol of 2-input NOR gate. And it indicates that OR gate followed by a NOT gate. That in logic circuits, in digital circuits, a small circle always indicates the function of a NOT gate. The function of a NOT gate. So it is equal to y equal to A plus B whole bar. Similarly, for a 3-input gate, here we have to write or draw a bubble. So write the output expression as y equal to a plus b plus c whole bar. So what is the function of this gate? Simply, its truth table is inversion of the OR gate. Inversion of the OR gate. Simply complement the outputs of the OR gate outputs. So simply, if you want to write the outputs of the complement of these outputs, so write here 1, 0, 0, 0. So for your convenience, simply write the same values. 1, 0, 0, 0. What is this one? The truth table of 2-input NOR gate. What is its function observed? Simply, it produces high output only when all the inputs are low. And it produces high output in only one case. That is, when all the inputs are low. When all the inputs are low. In any other case, it produces a low output. Low output. So obviously, what is output for what is the output for three input NOR gate? It produces high output only when all the inputs are low. In all other cases, it produces a low output. So this is the logic symbols. These are the logic symbols, and these are the truth tables for two input and three input NOR gates. Two input and three input NOR gates. Next, once again, consider the function of an AND gate. It is already discussed in the last class. What is the function of an AND gate? So this is the logic symbol for a two input and three input AND gates. So A and B are the inputs and Y is the output. Output expression Y equal to A into B, AB. In this case, Y equal to A, B, C. What is the function of an AND gate? It produces high output only when all the inputs are high. So in this case only it produces high output. In all other cases it produces a low output. That is the function of an AND gate. In this case also, it produces high output only when all the inputs are high. In all other cases, it produces low outputs. So this is the function of an AND gate, A and B AND gate. If you consider the NAND gate, that is a negation of AND gate. Same as with the NOR gate, it is a negation of OR gate. So it is nothing but an AND gate followed by a NOT gate. So Y equal to AB whole bar. In other words, actual logic symbol for AND gate is we have to write a bubble at the output of an AND gate, then it becomes an AND gate. In this case also, we have to write a bubble. Simply write the, for the truth table, write the inversion of the AND gate truth table. So this is AND gate truth table. What is its inversion? 1, 1, 1, 0. So write here, 1, 1, 1, and 0. Observe the function of the NAND gate. It's a very, very important one, NAND gate. If it has one input or more than one input is 0, it produces high output. Memorize that one. If it has one input or more than one input is 0, it produces a high output. A simple other words, no doubt in that one. If any one input of the NAND gate is 0, it produces a high output. Memorize this one. If any one input of the NAND gate is 0, it produces a high output. any one input of the NAND gate is zero, it produces a high output. In other words, when it produces low output, only when all the inputs are high. Only when all the inputs are high. So similarly, a three input NAND gate also. When it produces low output, when all the inputs are high. When it produces high output, when any one of the input is low. So that is a function of the NAND gate. Once again, memorize, what is the function of a NAND gate? NAND gate produces high output when any one of the input is low. Or in other words, when it produces low output, only when all the inputs are high. So this is the logic symbol and truth tables for NAND gate. Next one is the exclusive OR gate. Exclusive OR gate. It can be written as a XOR gate, EXOR gate, or XR gate. All are valid. It is an XOR gate, EXOR gate, or exclusive OR gate. This is the logic symbol for two input exclusive OR gate. And actually at the input of the OR gate symbol, there is one more curve. There is one more curve. Then it is a symbol for exclusive OR gate. So if A and B are the inputs and Y is the output, output expression Y can be written as A, that is the exclusive OR symbol, a plus symbol within the circle, plus symbol within the circle represents the exclusive OR symbol, A exclusive OR B. A exclusive OR B. For a three input exclusive OR gate, this is a symbol for a three input OR gate, and here for the exclusive OR gate, there is one more curve. So A, B, C. Y equal to A exclusive OR B, exclusive OR C. A exclusive OR B, exclusive OR C. The function of exclusive OR gate is for a two input gate, follow carefully, for a two input gate. If the inputs are different, and in this case A equal to 0, B equal to 1, different. In this case A equal to 1, B equal to 0. In these two cases, inputs are different. So, it produces high output. Exclusive, two input exclusive OR gate produces high output when the inputs are different. Or in other words, it produces zero output when the inputs are the same. When the inputs are the same, 0, 0 case, and A equal to 0, B equal to 0, that means inputs are the same. Here A equal to 1, B equal to 1, inputs are the same. When the inputs are the same, it produces 0 output, and when the inputs are different, it produces 1 output. For a two input exclusive OR gate. To write the truth table of a three input exclusive OR gate. It produces high output. It produces high output when the inputs have odd number of ones. It produces high output only when the input has odd number of ones. Odd number of ones. And for example, observe this one: 0, 0, 0. No ones are there, so it produces zero output. In this case of 0, 0, 1, how many number of ones are there? Only one. So odd number of ones, it produces high output. In this case also odd number, only one, so odd number of ones, it produces high output. In this case two ones, so it's an even number, it produces low output. In this case 1, 0, 0, only one, odd number of ones, high output. 1, 0, 1, two ones, even number, zero output. 1, 1, 0, even number. And the two ones, even number, zero output. 1, 1, 1, three ones, odd number of ones, high output. So this is the truth table for a three input exclusive OR gate. Three input exclusive OR gate. Three input exclusive OR gate, memorize this one, produces high output when the input has odd number of ones. Odd number of ones. So this is the truth table for three input exclusive OR gate. This is the logic symbol, and that is output expression for two input exclusive OR gate. This is the truth table, and that is the logic symbol. Next type of gate. Exclusive NOR gate. Write it as XNOR or XNOR. So exclusive NOR gate. Obviously, it is nothing but a exclusive OR gate followed by a NOT gate. Exclusive OR gate followed by a NOT gate. So, let's say circle here. So here, there is no need to write A exclusive OR B whole bar. So write it as, put a dot here and place it within a circle. Dot within a circle indicates that is a function of an exclusive NOR operation. That is a function of exclusive NOR operation. So Y equal to A exclusive NOR B. In this case also, place a circle here. And this one also, A exclusive NOR B exclusive NOR C. What is the function of exclusive OR gate? It produces for two input exclusive OR gate. For two input exclusive OR gate. It produces high output when the inputs are different for exclusive OR gate. So obviously for exclusive NOR, in this case it produces high output, low, low and high. Or simply in other words, for exclusive NOR gate, 1, 0, 0, 1. And no doubt in that one. Truth table of two input exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of truth table of two input exclusive OR gate. No doubt in that one. Truth table of two input exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of truth table of two input exclusive OR gate. are simply, in other words, if you observe the function of exclusive NOR gate, two input exclusive NOR gate, when it produces high output, when the inputs are the same. So exclusive NOR gate produces high output when the inputs are equal. So one of the important application of exclusive NOR gate is equality detected. One of the important application of exclusive NOR gate is equality detected, and it can be used to detect whether the inputs are the same or not. So if the inputs are the same, it produces high output, and there's no doubt in that one. For a two-input exclusive NOR gate, if the output is high, it indicates that both the inputs are the same, both the inputs are equal. In other words, if the inputs are different, it produces low output. So what is one of the application of exclusive NOR gate? Equality detected. Equality detected. Don't get confused. For a three-input NOR gate, what is the truth table of three-input NOR gate? It is the inversion of truth table of three-input OR gate. What is the truth table of three-input NAND gate? It is the inversion of the truth table of the three-input AND gate. But in the case of exclusive NOR gate, truth table of three-input exclusive NOR gate is the same as the truth table of the three-input exclusive OR gate. Memorize this. It's a very, very important point. Truth table of three-input exclusive NOR gate is the same as with the truth table of three-input exclusive OR gate. And in the later classes, if you write the actual expression for three-input exclusive OR gate and three-input exclusive NOR gate, both are the same. In later classes, after two or three classes, if you write the expressions for three-input exclusive OR and three-input exclusive NOR gates, the output expressions are the same. For the time being, no doubt in that one, truth table of three-input exclusive NOR gate is same as with truth table of three-input exclusive OR gate. So this is the truth table of three-input exclusive NOR gate also. No doubt in that one. For a four-input NOR gate, truth table of four-input NOR gate is same as with the inversion of the truth table of four-input OR gate. In the case of AND and NAND gates, the truth table of four-input NAND gate is the inversion of the truth table of four-input AND gate. In the case of exclusive OR and exclusive NOR gates, follow carefully. The truth table of four-input exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of the truth table of four-input exclusive OR gate. For a four-input gate, no doubt in that one, truth table of exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of the truth table of four-input exclusive OR gate. For five-input, let us assume, for five-input gates, if it is a five-input exclusive NOR gate, the truth table of five-input exclusive NOR gate is same as with the truth table of five-input exclusive OR gate. For a six-input, and for example, for a truth table of six-input exclusive NOR gate, it is the inversion of the truth table of six input exclusive OR gate. So finally, as a conclusion, for the odd number of inputs, and a 3-input gate, 5-input gate, 7-input gate, etc. 3, 5, 7, etc. For odd number of input variables, truth table of exclusive OR and exclusive NOR is the same. Memorize this one, it's a very, very important part. For odd number of input variables, and here ABC are the variables. There are three. So odd number of variables. Truth table of exclusive NOR and exclusive OR are the same. For even number of input variables, for example, if the input variables are A, B, C, and D, and Y is the output, how many rows are there in the truth table? 2 to the power 4, that is equal to 16 rows. 16 rows. So in that case, the truth table of exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of the truth table of exclusive OR gate. For even number of input variables, say for 4 or 6 or 8, etc., truth table of exclusive NOR gate is the inversion of the truth table of the exclusive OR gate. So for a 3-input exclusive NOR gate, the truth table is same as with the truth table of 3-input exclusive OR gate. Say for example, for a 3-input exclusive OR or exclusive NOR gate, when it produces high output, if the input has odd number of ones, for the exclusive NOR gates, if the input has even number of variables, it produces high output when the input has even number of variables. So to write the truth table of a 4-input exclusive NOR gate, no doubt in that one, it produces high output when the input has a odd number of ones. To write the truth table of a 4-input exclusive NOR gate, write the truth table as it produces high output when the input has even number of ones. That's the truth table of exclusive NOR gate. Is there any confusion in exclusive OR and exclusive NOR gates? No doubt in that one. First point is, observe the functions of 2-input gates, exclusive OR and exclusive NOR. Next, observe the 3-input gates. No doubt in that one. Or simply in other words, for exclusive OR gate, whether it is 3 or 4 or 5 or any number of input variables, if it has odd number of ones, it produces high output. No doubt in that one. For exclusive OR gate. For exclusive NOR gate, if it has odd number of input variables, it produces high output when the input has odd number of ones. If it has the input, even number of input variables, it produces high output when the input has even number of ones. Any doubts? Take 1 minute time and any doubts? Any doubts? What are the different types of gates? R and NOT, NAND, NOR, XOR, XNOR. So these are the different types of gates. How many number? So 7 gates. AND, OR, NOT, NAND, NOR, XR, XNOR. X means exclusive. X means exclusive OR, exclusive NOR. I write here EXR or EXNOR. Exclusive OR, exclusive NOR gates. Out of all these gates, these three OR and NOT gates are called as basic gates, basic or fundamental gates. Basic or fundamental gates. Particularly these two gates, NAND and NOR, are called as universal gates. Or in other words, AND, OR and NOT gates are called as basic building blocks, and they are used to realize the logic circuits. So these gates are used to realize the logic circuits. So they are called as building blocks. Need to build the logic circuits. These were the basic building blocks. And these two are called as the universal building blocks. Universal building blocks. Why these two gates are called as the universal building blocks? Any logic expression can be realized by using only NAND gates. Are by using only NOR gates. And we can realize any logical expression by using only NAND gates. Similarly, we can realize any logical expression by using only NOR gates. So they are called as universal gates. And it is not possible to realize the given logic expression by using only OR gates, not possible. By using only AND gates, not possible. By using only exclusive OR gates, not possible. By using only exclusive NOR gates, not possible. We can realize any logical expression by using only NAND gates, by using only NOR gates. So they are called as universal gates. Universal gates. Next, we have to observe in the later process the realization of logical expressions. Realization of logical expressions by using AND or NOT gates, by using only NAND gates, by using only NOR gates, etc. after 2 or 3 classes. Actually, in the market, gates are available in the IC form, integrated circuit form, all are 14 pin ICs. It's an integrated circuit. It has 14 pins with DIP packets, and a DIP means a dual in line package, DIP DIP package. In our syllabus, there are different IC numbers are mentioned. Say 7400. I think. What are the other IC numbers in our syllabus? Seven four zero two, 7404, 7408, 7432, 7486. We have to observe the pin configurations of these ICs. If you observe in our WhatsApp group, there is a pin configuration of ICs. For example, actually, the technical name for 7400 IC is, it's a quad 2-input NAND gate. And it's a NAND gate IC. How many number of, and it's a 2-input NAND gates, and the 2-input NAND gates are there in that IC. How many number of 2-input NAND gates are there in that IC? Quad means 4. 4 2-input NAND gates are there in that one. 4 2-input NAND gates. So 7402, it's a quad 2-input NOR gate. Seven four zero eight. It's a quad 2-input AND gate. 7432. It's a quad 2-input R gate. 7486. It's a quad 2-input exclusive R gate. Exclusive R gate. And actually, it is not mentioned in our syllabus. If you observe 74266. 74266, it is a quad 2-input XNOR gate. What is this one? It's an X inverted. Inverter means not gate. Inverter means not gate. Hex means 6. So in that IC, there are 6 not gates. 6 not gates. Take 1 minute time and memorize the IC numbers for the gates. 7400 NAND gate. All are CRAD2 inputs, all are CRAD2 inputs except 7404. Forget about the CRAD2 input, and these are all the 2 input gates. CRAD means there are 4 ICs in that, 4 gates in that IC. So 7400, memorize 7400 NAND, 7402 NOR, 7408 AND, 7432 R, 7486 exclusive R, 74266 exclusive NOR. Exclusive NOR. Actually, the first 2 digits of the IC, that means 74, it's a 74 series ICs. 74 series ICs. 74 stands for TTL logic family. There are different logic families in the fabrication of ICs. In the fabrication of ICs, there are different logic families. So TTL is the one logic family. TTL, transistor, transistor logic. Other logic families are RTL, RTL, and the resistor, transistor logic. DTL, diode, transistor logic. ECL, emitter, coupled logic. And CMOS, complementary metal oxide semiconductor logic family. So these are all, there are number of other logic families also, I2L, etc. I2L means integrated injection logic. I2L means IIL, integrated injection logic, etc. So these are all the different logic families to fabricate the ICs. So 74 series indicates it's a TTL logic family. TTL logic family. If you observe the internal structure of 7400, 7408, 7432, 7486, 74266. The internal structure is the same for all these 5 ICs. 7402 NOR gate is different from these ICs. It's an X inverter, obviously, its pin configuration is different, no doubt in that one. Don't forget about this one. The pin configuration of 7402 NOR gate IC is different from other ICs. If you observe the pin configurations, say for your convenience, say no doubt in that one, all are 14 pin ICs. All are 14 pin ICs. Actually, in the case of integrated circuits, for proper operation, we have to apply a supply voltage and a ground to the IC. And to work with properly, for an IC, we have to apply supply voltage, that is the VCC. It is equal to, for 74 series ICs, 5 volts. We have to apply VCC of 5 volts and a ground terminal, and a GND, ground terminal, and a 0 volts. So no doubt in that one. For all these ICs, two pins are reserved for supply and ground. Supply and ground. No doubt in that one. In all those 14 pins, it's a 14 pin IC. 14 pins. 14th pin is the supply voltage VCC, and the 7th pin is the ground. 14th pin is the supply voltage, and 7th pin is the ground. So for your reference, for 74, zero zero. What is 7400? It's a NAND gate. It's a NAND gate. So this is the pin configuration of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Actually, this is the top view of the IC. This is the top view of the IC. So these are all the pins. These are all the pins. So one side there are 7 pins and the other side there are 7 pins. So they are numbered in a anti-clockwise direction as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Once again, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And actually, if you place the IC as shown in this figure, so this is the groove on the top of the IC, and there is a cut on the top of the IC. So this is the pin number one. As in other words, in some ICs, here there is a dot. That dot indicates pin number one. That dot indicates pin number one. For 7400, it's an AND gate. In this one, there are four two input NAND gates. So pin number 14 is reserved for supply voltage VCC, and pin number 7 for ground. Pin number 7 ground and pin number 14 VCC for all the ICs. Pin number 14 is reserved for supply and pin number 7 for ground. So the remaining number of pins are 12. So for each gate, it requires two inputs and one output. So for each gate, how many number of input and outputs? Three. Two inputs and one output. So for four gates, 4 into 3, so 12 pins. So this is for one NAND gate. For that one, 1 and 2 are the inputs and 3 is the output. For NAND gate 1, 1 and 2 are the inputs and 3 is the output. For the second AND gate, 4 and 5 are the inputs and 6 is the output. For the next AND gate, 13 and 12 are the inputs and 11 is the output. For the next NAND gate, 9 and 10 are the inputs and 8 is the output. So this is the pin configuration. This is the pin configuration. So the, for the first NAND gate, 1 and 2 are the inputs, 3 is the output. For the first second NAND gate, 4 and 5 are the inputs, 6 is the output. For the next one, 13 and 12 are the inputs and 11 is the output. For the next one, 10 and 9 are the inputs and 8 is the output. This is for 7400 IC. Say for example, for 7432, it's an R gate, R gate. So for that one, simply change the symbols. Draw the symbols for R gates here. Remaining pin numbers is the same. For 7408 AND gate, change the logic symbols of gates. 7486, it's an exclusive OR gate. So draw the, here the symbol for exclusive OR gates. Pin numbers is the same. 74266, for exclusive NOR gates, symbols is the same. But only doubt is, seven four zero two. For that one, this is an OR gate symbol. One is the output. 2 and 3 are the inputs. 1 is the output, 2 and 3 are the outputs. Next, 4 is the output, 5 and 6 are the inputs. Next, 13 is the output, 12 and 11 are the inputs. Next, 10 is the output, 9 and 8 are the outputs. That is a difference between other ICs and 7402. For 7402, 1 is the output, 2 and 3 are the inputs, 4 is the output, 5 and 6 are the inputs, etc. For 7404, say for hex inverter, in that one 6 NOT gates are there. Say for the first NOT gate, 1 is the input, 2 is output. For the second NOT gate, 3 is the input, 4 is output. For the third NOT gate, 5 is the input, 6 is output. For the next one, 13 is the input, 12 is output. For the next one, 11 is the input, 10 is output. For the next one, 9 is the input, 8 is output. That is for 7404. It's an X inverter. In that one, there are 6 NOT gates. 6 NOT gates. These are the pin configurations. Okay. Observe the pin configurations in your notes for your reference. Okay. We will meet in the next class.